Hey everyone, welcome to a new Quick Edit video. And this time I want to create another glowing mushroom image, since I want to finish working on this Lightroom catalog, which has almost 20,000 images, which is slowing down my PC a lot. But let's just take a look at the before and after images before I start the editing. And as always, for those kind of shots, I'm going to combine multiple images, with this one being the base image and this one being the images which I will merge later in Photoshop for this glow effect. Let's start on the base image. First, of course, I'm checking the lens correction settings. Then let's switch the camera profile to Adobe Standard, which will reduce the contrast a little bit by making the darker areas brighter. Then I want to work on the white balance. Important note here, I want to turn this into a rather blue shot, which will work great with the light of the mushroom later. So I can simply drop the temperature until I find a nice spot for a blue color tone. Something like this I think looks pretty cool. And in my opinion, this will also help creating this magic, mysterious mood for this picture. So then let's go on by dropping the highlights and let's increase the shadows just so we have some detail in the darker areas. Of course, due to the reduced highlights and increased shadows, the photo is now lacking a bit of contrast. So let's fix that by simply increasing the contrast. Okay. That's it for the global adjustments for now. Next, let's check out some local adjustments. As you can see, I have created a gradiated filter for the top part of the image, which I just want to darken a little bit by dropping the exposure. Okay, and I also have created two radial filters. This small little one is just for the sharp part of the mushroom, which I want to further sharpen by increasing the texture and the clarity. And then the last radial filter is for everything outside this area. And I want to apply some kind of fake vignetting effect, but I don't want to affect the bright areas, so I'm dropping the shadows instead of the exposure. And then to make everything in the background a little bit smoother, I'm dropping the texture and the clarity. Alright, that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's do a little bit of color grading, but there's not much to do. I simply want to drop the blue saturation a tiny bit. And then use the split toning to apply a cold color tone to the highlights. And a cold color tone for the shadows. And again, this will just help creating this magical and mysterious look for this image. And don't worry about having too much blue in here. The glow of the mushroom will work really, really good with the blue in the background. So next, let's sharpen this picture. And also, finally, let's apply a little bit of vignetting. Okay, cool. Then, of course, I have to copy the settings for the base image onto the glow images. And here I can simply hit the previous button. And you can see I have copied over the settings. Then let's do this for the third shot as well. Okay, and now I'm selecting those three images. Right click on the thumbnail and go to edit in and open as layers in Photoshop. Alright, and here we have our three images stacked on top of each other as layers. And you might notice the images aren't aligned perfectly, so let's fix that. Therefore I'm selecting all three layers, go to edit and hit the auto align layers button. And here I'm not changing anything, just hit OK. And Photoshop will now align those images perfectly, as you can see. Then let's work on merging everything together. I'm simply creating a layer mask. Then I want to invert the mask, this way making it black by hitting Ctrl I. And with the foreground color set to white, I'm using the brush tool to paint back in the glow on the mushroom. Alright, and I'm doing the same thing for the second glow layer. Apply a layer mask, invert the mask, and paint in the glow. And that's it for merging the base image with the glow images. Next, I want to merge those three photos by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. So next, I want to brighten up the picture a bit by applying an adjustment layer. So let's click this little icon right there, go to brightness and contrast. And I'm simply increasing the brightness. And this way it looks much, much better. And the next step for me would be to work on this glowing mushroom itself for a little bit. And in fact, I want to make the glow a little bit more interesting. So let's create a new layer and switch the blending mode to hard light. Then let's zoom in a little bit. And with the brush tool selected, I'm hitting the Alt key and click on a bright area inside the mushroom. And this way I can pick up the color from there. And to paint in some glow, I'm dropping the brush opacity to 10% and use a really, really small brush here. And then I'm carefully painting in some glow. Okay, this is a very subtle change, but it makes a big difference in my opinion. So to finish the editing, I want to go through the Nick collection, but first I need to merge everything again. And then let's go through the Color Effects Pro filter list. And here I want to go with the classical soft focus, which I mainly want to apply on the background, since it does make it more interesting. And I'm going with the first soft focus method to not lose any brightness. Okay. And as said, I don't want it over the whole image. So I have created another layer mask on that classical soft focus layer. And here I'm using a black foreground color to brush out a few areas, mainly the mushroom and some parts of the foreground. All right, then one more thing I need to fix. Since I have used the auto align tool earlier, there are some strange borders on this image, as you can see. So I'm just cropping out a small part of the picture. Okay, and that's it for this glowing mushroom image. I hope this video was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.